He makes me lie down in green pastures, leads me beside quiet waters.
Shalom, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I'm Dr. Israel Christy-Leary. Welcome to Green Pastures, especially this segment I've tagged Elevation Capsule. I see God lifting you up from your valley, whatever valley it may be. You are coming out of it strong and better in the name of Jesus. We are looking at the book I wrote many years back, titled This Valley Shall Be Filled. We've been able to consider the Valley of Achor a few weeks back. And yes, last week we looked at the Valley of Shurek. We began with Valley of Shurek. What do you know that it was at this valley that the man Samson met with Delilah, who destroyed his life. The story of Delilah is the third example of Samson's moral weakness. Through her, Samson broke his third Nazareth vow. After withstanding her first three advances, she later got him in the area of his weakness. But it's noteworthy that Samson first met with her, not in any other place, but at the Valley of Shurek. Delilah's home was in the Valley of Shurek, the long valley between Jerusalem and the Mediterranean Sea. In the land of the Philistines, at the Valley of Shurek, Samson met with a woman who was instrumental to his historical downfall. That woman that will destroy you, may God not allow you to meet. And if you are already meeting with her, may God separate you from her before she destroys your life in the name of Jesus. What are the characteristics and significance of the Valley of Shurek? Number one, it is a valley of temptation. The Valley of Shurek, according to the KJV Bible commentary, was a place where many people mingled freely. The name Delilah actually means seduction. So at the Valley of Shurek, Samson met with seduction. Samson met with seduction, and he paid the price for it. And it was a big price he paid. Every Christian will have to go through the valley of temptation. But when you are there, do not stay there. To be tempted is not sinful, but yielding is sin. If our Lord Jesus Christ was tempted, none of us could be immune from temptation. Therefore, be careful when you find yourself in the valley of temptation. Number two, it is also a valley of choice or decision of eternal consequence. Now, just like in the valley of Achor, the valley of Shurek is also a valley of choice. It was the choice of Samson that led to his downfall. He sacrificed his power for pleasure. He chose Delilah instead of the scriptures. There is always a choice for you and I to make when we find ourselves at the valley of Shurek. The truth of God's word, the righteousness of God on one hand, or the fall for the lies and the unrighteousness of the devil. Whenever the devil comes your way with the persuasive and enticing words, remember you are God and you must decide for God. Your decision at the valley of Shurek will determine whether you will rise up or you will go down. May you not go down in the name of Jesus. As we conclude this chapter, remember you must run away from the valley of Achor and the valley of Shurek. You must make right decision at the valley of Shurek. When the devil tempts you to cheat, be determined to be faithful. A rich man invited seven of his friends to his house. They were not as rich as him for a lunch, but they all forgot to come. Well, he told them when they were coming, they should come with a bottle of wine for him. But they all thought in their minds, our friend has enough. Why will he be asking us to come with the bottle of wine? They all came and they decided not to come with any bottle. They decided not to come with wine, but they put water in the bottle. But according to the story, when they all arrived, he simply served them food. And he told them, drink the bottle of wine you have brought. Unfortunately, all of them, instead of drinking wine, they drank water. Today, God is saying we should not cheat on our Christian race. The one who cheats in his Christian race simply cheats himself. All God's laws are for our benefit. So when you get to the valley of Sorek, I say to you, make the right choice. See you next week as we continue to study. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.